Dear students, let us discuss about bonds in solids. See, there is an important question will come in university exams and also in some competitive exams regarding these bonds in solids. And there are two types of bonds in each and every material. Let us see, there are two types of bonds. The first one is a primary bond. The second one is a secondary bond. Let us see first what is the basic difference between primary bond and a secondary bond. The basic difference is a bond strength. Let us see how the bond strength in primary bond and in secondary bond. See, bond strength is a high in primary bond. In case of secondary, it is a less strength or strength is weak. Okay, primary bonds are having high bond strength, secondary bonds are having low bond strength or less bond strength, low bond strength or less bond strength. And what is the interatomic distance? See, interatomic distance is nothing but the distance between atoms. There is atom number 1 and atom number 2. So how that distance between the atoms, which tells the interatomic distance. See, interatomic distance is a low or less in primary bond and interatomic distance is high. The third one, examples. The first one is bond strength, the second one is interatomic distance, and third one is a example. Example for primary bond. First one, ionic bond and covalent bond. One, metallic bond. Third one, metallic bond. And secondary bonds example, Van der Waals bond, and second one, hydrogen bond. Now let us see one by one. Now we will see about ionic bond. How the ionic bond forms? First of all, what is bond? What is bond? See, bond is formed due to electrostatic force. There is an electrostatic force exists between two atoms, and that electrostatic force is called as bond. Now, why is electrostatic force is forming between two atoms? Why? Because see, there are two atoms, and there is one possibility is one atom becomes positive ion and another atom becomes negative ion. So atoms becomes ions or charges. Why? Because of transferring of electrons. So whenever there is a positive ion and negative ion, there should be electrostatic force between these two ions. So why these atoms are become positive or negative? Because of transferring of electrons. Okay? So whenever there is a charge, then there is a possibility for electrostatic force. So we can see these type of charges in ionic bonded materials and in metallic bonded materials. In covalent bond is formed due to sharing of electrons, that we will discuss later. So what we have seen up to now, what is bond? Bond is nothing but electrostatic force which exists between two atoms. So there is a bond exists between two atoms. That is because of electrostatic force. Why electrostatic force is generating? Because of charge. Why charge is forming? Because of movement of electrons. So one atom loses electron and another atom gains electron. So due to this, charge forms. Due to charge, electrostatic force. Due to electrostatic force, bond exists. Okay. So movement of electrons we can see in ionic and metallic bonds. Okay, now let us see ionic bond. There is a traditional example for ionic bonded material, which is a sodium chloride, which is what we are using in our food, which is salt, right? Salt, sodium chloride. So what happens here? Sodium chloride material consists of sodium plus ions and chlorine negative ions, Na plus and Cl minus. So why Na becomes positive? Because sodium loses electron, okay, and chlorine gains electron, okay. Sodium loses electron, that's why it become positive. Chlorine gains electron, that's why it becomes negative ion. So whenever there is a charge, there is a positive charge and negative charge, then there would be bond formation between sodium ion and chlorine ion. So thereby ionic bond, thereby this type of bond is called as ionic bond. Ionic bond is formed by transferring of electrons. What are the properties? The first property is it is having high strength, and second one, high hardness, third one, high brittleness, and fourth one, transparent and to light, having good electrical conductivity. Of you, and what are example? The main traditional example is sodium chloride. Okay, so what is ionic bond? Ionic bond is nothing but the bond which is formed due to transferring of electrons between two atoms. So example is sodium chloride. So sodium is having one extra electron, so it can donate an electron. So sodium donates an electron, that's why it become positive Na plus. Chlorine wants one electron, okay, thereby it gains an electron from sodium, thereby it becomes negative. So we are having sodium plus ion and chlorine minus ion, then there is a bond exists between Na plus and Cl minus. So that is ionic bond. Now let us discuss covalent bond. It is formed between two atoms and those are sharing electron, okay. So due to sharing of electrons we are having covalent bond. Hydrogen, Cl2, these are gases. So here one important point is the covalent bond may form in gases or in solids, whereas ionic bond forms in solids only. Ionic bond forms in solids and covalent bond forms in gases and solids. So these two hydrogen atoms will share electron, thereby we are having covalent bond. First one, we are having very high strength, and second one, very high hardness, and third one, very high brittleness, and fourth one, a good electrical conductivity. And fifth one, it is opaque to light. These examples for covalent bonds are majorly, you can see hydrogen, chlorine, and we can see diamond, okay, and we can see in graphite.